Okay, so welcome to my presentation, how to make an amazing profile on GitHub. This is a relatively new feature, relatively because the feature was introduced 1 year ago, but I discovered that really not many Czech developers know about the feature. And the feature is that you can put your personal section on your GitHub profile where you can include almost anything. So let's see some examples. I tried to show you examples of Czech developers. Okay, first Czech developer is actually Slovak developer, Ricky Friedrich. Hello, Friedrich. And what I'm talking about is this section. This is completely new. Some place where you can put anything personal about you. So with this, you can use GitHub like a social network for your personal presentation. Ricky is really modest man. He's using only plain text feature, but let's go to the second person, Milan Felix Schulz. You can see he's using the pictures. It's still the static, I will show you later. It's the static text, but you can use some interactivity. For example, here, this is the counter. If you are old enough, and if you remember how the internet was in the 90s, at that time, every web page has the counter, which was counted how many visitors was there on the web page. Hello, this is the counter. If I reload the page, you can see the counter is increasing. Okay, this is maybe not useful, only funny things. And the second thing is trying to show the repositories that Milan have. We can check how this is done. If I ever found any profile and I wonder how he does it, it's very easy. We are on a GitHub. I will go to the detail. It will show me the repository. I will open the README file. See the raw, and now I can even see that the Milan Schulz is cheating. Sorry, Milan, but we have discovered this because this badge is the fake badge. You can include there any number that you want. Okay, bad gateway. One more time. Yes, but if you want, this badge, you can include it and even more. Okay, the first Czech developer is me, okay? I like emoji, I put the emoji there. If you hate emoji, please don't put emoji there. I tried to put there more information, but I wanted to be short. So one feature that I will show you is this, how you can really collapse more information to the one line. So your profile look really short, but you can have there more information. And there are some interactive graphs that I will show you later. Okay, so how is this feature called? This is profile README on GitHub. And how can you create one? Okay. You create repository with the name same as is your username. If we check here, it's always the repository with the same name as your username. Second step, you will create the README file, profit. And this is all. There is nothing more, no more magic. So let's try to start one. I will start here, and because I do not want to destroy my alt text, I will use the feature on the GitHub. I will create new branch called Posobota. Okay, I created branch Posobota. I will reset the readme to the original state, how you can see it when you create the empty profile. It looks like this. And now I change my default branch to the branch Posobota. Update. Yes. So now you can see my changes are live. This is very useful because if you want to make some text experiments, you can make more branches. You can have your stable branch with your stable profile and then as many branches as you want with your experimental versions. And in just a second, you can switch between them. So, and if you check what is there, it's really simple file. It's the markdown. You have some pretext prepared here. I can uncomment, commit, and I can immediately see the changes. Okay. So, but sometimes we want to have there more than text. So looks, check what is there more. Okay, first we talk this. This is the markdown, plus you can use HTML. Not every HTML, you know, this is markdown GitHub. You cannot use JavaScript, you cannot use cascading styles, but you can use pretty much. You can use images. If you want to have some interactivity, you can use even animated GIFs, or you can use SVG images. SVG can contain CSS animations, and with them you can do really a lot. You can use GitHub branches, as I showed you before, if you want to switch between more versions. And you can use whole GitHub ecosystem. I will show you some example because imagine in the beginning, this is just static text file, but you can really have there some interactivity if you use the clever things on the GitHub. Let's see some more examples. Just this funny one that I liked. Okay, maybe this is not a useful example, but this is definitely cool. Every time if you wonder how is the profile made, you just click on the link, check how is the readme done, and in this case, you see that it's just one GIF image that is making the whole miracle. Okay, let's see another example in the similar style. It's like this. It's making Tetris on the GitHub. Okay, and the last animated example, last, I promise. I really like this one. You very probably know this game in the browser. When I saw for the first time, I tried to play the game, but you cannot play, it's only GIF. So this is what you can do with the pictures, of course. And there is a little trick how you can use GitHub Cloud for the pictures. I'm not sure if you know the trick, so I will show you because otherwise you can upload picture into your repository, but you know it's GitHub, so the picture will be there forever. Your repository will grow forever. And especially when you are just making experiments, you want to upload pictures very quickly. And GitHub has a picture cloud for the pictures from the users. It's only a little bit hidden. And it's used in the comments. So if you put picture in any comments, anywhere on the GitHub, in discussions, in the issues, GitHub automatically upload a picture in his clouds and you can use it. So for this, I'm having open issue. This is issue just for me. And this is issue that I use only for uploading my pictures. So for example, I want to put there some my new picture. I will try to drag and drop it here. Drag and drop. GitHub is working. Now GitHub uploaded picture into his cloud. I can submit the comment and I can put the picture into my profile very quickly. And I really do not need to care where to upload the picture, where to commit or not. And the trick of this issue is because there is no user interface where you can find your uploaded pictures. If you uploaded 100 pictures and you lost the URL, you cannot find them. So the trick is, if I upload all the pictures with my issues, I can very quickly, anytime, find all my pictures here. So this is GitHub Cloud. And now check what we can do with SVG pictures. I really like this one. Check this profile. Okay, it's some Indian developer. And he has these amazing graphs that I create dynamically from his GitHub repositories. And these graphs are SVG pictures because it's the only way how he can easily put there this interactivity. If you want them to, we can check. This developer even created project for you. It's called GitHub README Stats, and he prepared many different graphs that you can use. There are many different. There are many options for the design and for information that you want to use. I will go to the language card and imagine that I want to put my languages into my GitHub profile. So I will edit my README and I will put here the graph. But this is not my graph, this is his graph. I must rename, get rid of this. I must just rename here in the URL the parameter. And now I see here. And you can see this is my statistic. If I want to tweak it a little bit, for example, I do not want to present that I'm programming in the Lua. Yes, there is a clever parameter for this. I just can write height Lua. And this is it. I commit and I can use you can see only the languages that I want to show this to you. Okay, with these things, you can have here self-updated information from your working on the GitHub. There is one possible problem that you should be aware of. If you check this, application is working as Vercel application and is using GitHub API. And there is some limit of daily request for this GitHub API. So its author is warning us that if many people will use this link, will use this picture on the profile, he may reach the quota, and instead of the nice picture, we can see just loading image. Is this problem? Yes. Has this problem solution? Of course. Solution is very easy. We just go up and we will fork this project and we will deploy this project as our own Vercel application And voila, we have our own quota and there is no another problems. So I recommend you check these graphs. I really like it. There are many types. You do not need to write them down. Later, I will publish my presentation with all the links, all the examples that I show you now, so you can very easily find them. Okay, one thing that I want to show you, how to be short, because no one likes to read really long text, no one. But sometimes you want to put there a lot of text. So this is one trick, and the trick is to use HTML feature, details, and summary. These are the valid HTML tags. I have here some example prepared, and it looks like this. All the content inside the detail tag is shrink down only to one line that you can enlarge. And this is it, very easy. You can use even details into details, so you can use it as recursively. I prepare some example. For example, if I want to put there my curriculum, maybe I'm looking for a job, I have here prepared the text. So I want to include here a lot of information, but I want to keep my profile short. So I include here some virtual curriculum, my CV. I can enlarge it and you can see my first job, second job, third job. And there I can see more details for every job. This is clever usage of the details summary tags. Is there, you may ask if there is a nested limits, how many tags you can put inside. I didn't find in the documentation, but I tried and without problems, I was able to put in the 10 level nested limits, details into details into details, and it works very good. So I believe 10 level is enough for us. Just one thing you need to remember. You are writing HTML. It looks like HTML, but this is Markdown parser. So you must think in the Markdown thinking. So for example, if I do not write the blank line here, this is a problem, at least sometimes. If I commit this, oh, okay. Now this is working, but in some example, this is problem. And in the documentation, they are writing that the after summary is mandatory empty line. And even after ending details is mandatory empty lines. And when I was playing with this, really, when you do not put there empty lines, sometimes there is really big mess. So remember, it looks like HTML, but in the reality, this is Markdown look using HTML. So this was another clever feature. We can continue. Now I will show you some dynamic examples because we are still a little more static. All of this was the text that I prepared, and if there was some interactivity, it was only collapsing, opening, or it was some interactive pictures. But I will show you now how you can use ecosystem on the GitHub to dynamically update your README. And for this, first, I like this profile of Simon Willison, famous developer from the UK or San Francisco. I believe he's from UK. Okay. All his profile page is generated automatically. You can see There is a table in first column that are the recent releases of his application. In the next column, there are his recent article on his blog. And third column, this is articles from his microblog. Again, you may wonder how he is doing it. Very easy. You go and check his repository, and you can really see GitHub workflows, which means there must be some GitHub actions. And of course, there is some GitHub actions. You can see that he is building new README free time in an hour. We can check how he do this. You can check his setting. Now you can see there is the cron. So this GitHub action is started automatically. If you are like me and you are many times confused with the cron messages, I can show you just very quickly service. It's called CronTab Guru. And it works like this. It's crontab.guru. You will write here any numbers from the CronTab. I write here that I found here. And it will explain to you very quickly what's the real running. So this means that this GitHub action runs every 20 minutes, every hour at 8 minutes, 28, and 48 minutes. Is Simon Willison rebuilding his repository, his README. Okay, the beginning is boring. He will install the Python. And the most important is this. He will run build.me README script that we will check soon. And after that, he will commit the newly generated README to the profile. So we can just check for the, here is the build README. And the build README is using GraphQL API to download all information from the GitHub and from his blog. And in the end, he will generate his new README. I will not go to the details now, but if you like it, you can check here. It's really good example. And if you want, okay, it's easy. Just fork it, you see 100 fork, examine and run it. Very, very clever way. Okay, I found some more crazy examples now. See this guy, Jonathan. What is Jonathan doing here? What is this? This is a board game. This is board game called Connect Four. In Czech, we use Piškvorky, but this is some special version with the gravity. And what he's doing, he's playing Piškvorky with the visitors, or the visitors is playing Connect Four on his GitHub profile. How is he doing it? We will go into the details. Here you can see the last moves. I was checking yesterday. I was playing for the red. This was my move. Later played someone blue. So now is red on the turn. So I will try to make my next move. How we can make interactive page that is only static HTML page? And I really like the way how this is done. Okay, there are only now five possible moves. Move is that we may choose the column where we want to play, and we would put our piece there, and the piece will fall down. So I can choose 1, 2, 5, 6, 7. I'm not sure which move is. I definitely will not play first, because then I will lose the game immediately. Maybe I would like to play the 5, but not yet. I will prepare, so I will play the 7. So imagine I'm going to play the 7. So I click the 7, and now we will see how this game is done. It opening the issue page. And it opened the issue page, the template, and that is pre-generated all information about our move. You can see in the subject there is connect 4 and we are playing to the column 7. And when I submit this issue, which I do now, I'm making the move and I'm in the game. I submitted the issue. What is happening now? You know, there is GitHub Actions. So it's probably started some actions. Yes. And now there is working action that is processing my move. And now is checking if my move is okay. And it's regenerating his new stage. We can check here again how this is done in the action. You can find definition of the action. And most important, you can see here is some script written in Ruby, connect for runner. He ran that script, and after that, again, he will run some new commit. If we want to see the script, we can go here to the folder connect for, and I will not go to the details now. You can see how the game is played, and it's really very well documented here. You can find how the script is working, how the game is progressing. Okay, let's check if we make the move. Yes, here, this is our move. So I make the move for the red, and now anyone else can make a move for the blue. When I saw this, I think this is really crazy. Okay, first, definitely this is not anything useful. I know who won that people will play games on their profile, but it's very clever. I really admire how he is using the ecosystem on the GitHub for making static page dynamic. And I'm really sure that the creators of the GitHub was never thinking that the GitHub can be used as environment for online playing board games. And if you think that this guy is crazy and this is stupid game, then let's go to the page of the Tim Bergen that is employee of the GitHub. You can see GitHub staff and what he is doing. He's playing chess on his GitHub page and with a very similar logic. Now we have the game and there is the black on the turn. Okay, let's don't go on the details, but he doing in this way, he is generating the table of all possible moves. And if I want to move, I don't know which move can be. Maybe I want to attack this knight, so I will move my pawn a7 to a6. I will make a7 to a6. I will open again the issue, but this time I will not submit the issue. I do not want to spoil the game for the others, but you can imagine what will happen. There is again GitHub action. You can check the GitHub actions, and if you want the detail, you can check the GitHub workflow. So these are really crazy examples what is possible, what you can do there. Maybe you can imagine some more useful example. I don't know now, but maybe you can later. Okay, so let's move on. Now we are coming to the end of my presentation. So let's think what we saw. You saw some examples, some crazy one, but maybe now we are thinking, what is there for me? How can I make successful README profile that will help me? As a first step, I suggest you, even before you start making it, set your goals. You may have 1, 2, 3 goals, maybe not more. What is your goal, for example? Maybe you are a student and you are looking for your first job. Okay, this is perfect goal. So keep this in mind when you are making your profile. You are looking for a job. Maybe in that case is not the best playing chess game there. Maybe you want to put there some curriculum. Maybe you have different goal. Maybe you already have a job and you make some fantastic project on your GitHub and you are looking for friendly developers that will help you with your project. Focus on that. Focus on that on your README profile and try to impress developer why they should help you. Or maybe you have completely different goal. Maybe you are just writing a blog for developers and you want to get more attention, you want to get more readers. Focus on that. Probably you will put your recent articles or the link to your recent articles to your GitHub README profile. So focus on your goals. I suggest not many goals. 3 is really enough. Even 1 goal is enough. Focus on these goals. Try to be short. I showed you some trick how you can be short with collapsible section because no one like to read long text. Try to be clear because people do not know you. They do not know if you are joking or not. So try to be really clear. And be personal. This is your personal page. Today we saw many really personal page and many original page. I write here, you may be original, but maybe not. That depends on your goal. Think how much original you want to be when you are looking for a job and what kind of a job. So always be personal and only sometimes be original. And my last advice for you is always look for an inspiration. Here are 2 gallery of many inspirational GitHub profiles. At I can only quickly open. This is the first gallery. You can see link for many profiles. I'm more like the second one gallery because here you can see preview of many, many profiles. And if you like any of them, you can fork them, examine them, copy them. This is up to you. So, guys, we are at the end of my presentation. I hope it was inspiration to you, and I hope that soon there will be many fantastic GitHub profiles that will help you to find better jobs, to find better career, or to find friends that you want to play chess with. So, thank you.
Thank you, Martin. There is currently, oh yeah, there is one question. Philip is asking, how many hours did you spend on creating your profile?
I believe, because I was really examining all of these things. So maybe it was, maybe 3 hours, 3 or 4 hours. But after this presentation, you can do it more quickly. I believe you can do the same maybe in less than 1 hour.
Cool. And there is another question, which is kind of off topic, but I can answer it in a few seconds. So what we are streaming from, we are using OBS and streaming to YouTube. That's basically it, pretty standard stuff.